everybody and welcome to the channel. My name is Tlami and in this episode of Break the K, I'm gonna be reacting to two comebacks. The first one being Kang Daniel's Who You Are, and the second one being a group that I just stumbled upon on YouTube. It was recommended to me, so I decided to add it to my reaction list. That being the group One Team and their song ULLAELI KKOLLAELI. That's a very weird name. I think it's most likely a foreign name. I would guess maybe Hawaiian, I don't know. It just comes off as that, but I don't know, correct me if I'm wrong. So yeah, I'm a little bit more excited for that one because I have never listened to them, so I don't know what to expect. But at least for the Kang Daniel comeback, I'm hoping to like this one more because I know people love him a lot for his music, but so far for me, he hasn't really done too much. Like, he's not as unique as I would like him to be. So I'm hoping that maybe I like this comeback more. So yeah, without further ado, let's just jump into it. Starting off with Kang Daniel in 3, 2, 1. I like the set. Okay, so far so good. Okay, I feel like this one's a little bit more edgy, so I like it, that's for sure. But I'm really hoping to fall in love with it, but we'll see. Okay, I genuinely like it. I just hope it then ends up being a little bit explosive at some point, hopefully by the ending of the song. Because so far it's a bit too low-key for my taste. But everything else about it is pretty much my taste. I love the set of it. The setting of it, like the set. And the beat is definitely catchy, but it just needs that explosive chorus or breakdown. Oh, you are, definitely. Yeah, so far it's low-key catchy, but I really want it to be super catchy. We'll see whether it's gonna go there. Ooh, that's a really cool shot. Wait, is that him rapping? This part is so catchy, I just wish it had a little bit of a harder beat. Okay, I definitely like this. Okay, we're gonna just straight up get into it one more time, but just a quick few things to say about it. I love it. I'm not quite to the point of really being blown away. I think if the beat was a little bit harder, I would have been there, but as it stands, I like it. I definitely like it. I can for sure say that I'm going to listen to this. It's catchy enough for me, so yeah, I think I've reacted to him at one point. I think it might have been maybe 2 months ago. I think it was one of the first videos that I did once I came where I am now this year. Like it was probably at some point 2 months ago, and I'm fairly sure it was requested to me by my friend Yuri. But I don't really think I really enjoyed it that much. Like, it wasn't bad, but it wasn't even really that catchy to me. This one is genuinely catchy to me, but there's definitely some things to be desired in this one. The main thing that I feel like it's lacking in the song, it doesn't have an explosive feeling. And that is mainly because the beat is not hard enough, I feel. Because that part of the chorus where he sings "Who You Are," that's really catchy, but it doesn't have the weight it should have because the beat is not hard. But yeah, still, let's listen to it one more time in 3, 2, 1. Damn, the choreo is also really good. Oh yeah, on second listen it's already better. Even the parts which I didn't really care about during the first listen, like the more vocally based ones, like some part of the verses. I still think it should have been a little bit harder, but I like it. Sorry about that. You just wanna talk, you don't wanna walk, my you wanna see some good job to merge up a dog. Why can't you just have some fun with me? Moon pitch it down get mad, not in get young as in she can. Big guys hooks I get then I'm gonna blow your mind. She tells you and jig and booty. Hey, I just remembered. What happened with him and Gio from Twice? Weren't they together? Yeah, this part is so catchy. This is by far my favorite shot of the music video. Okay, is this him rapping? Because I think at some point I read something about it being a feature. I don't know if it was for this song or for some other. Probably it was for some other, but still. Man, I'm also really liking the choreo. Okay, so my wish was fulfilled. It was an actual good song that I actually ended up enjoying. I love when that happens. It's so satisfying because I had the same thing with The Boys. Like, I listened to them to almost every, I think pretty much every single title track that was released. And a lot of them, I just didn't find them catchy, but after they came back with the song Tattoo, that one was just a little bit more edgier, and I don't know, just there was just something about it that made me interested into it, that hooked me into it, that was really kind of lacking in the other songs. They weren't bad, mind you. I definitely recognized that they were catchy, but for some reason they didn't appeal to me, I guess. And it was kind of the same case with Kang Daniel, but with this one, I'd say I enjoyed it quite a lot, but my biggest complaint is definitely that the beat is not hard enough and rough enough. There's definitely something left to be desired there, but in terms of the lyrics, it's really catchy of the instrument. I mean, I guess you could say that's the instrumental. The dancing is also pretty cool. Even though he's a soloist, he's losing a lot of back dancers, and the choreo was really enjoyable. The setting of the music video was also interesting. But yeah, I guess I'm gonna give this one personally an 8.8 out of 10. I was considering giving it a 9.8, but I wouldn't say I was blown away enough to give it that rating. So I'm gonna leave it at an 8.8 out of 10. If the beat was harder, probably could have gone up to a 9.8 out of 10 or a 10 out of 10 even. But as it stands, I would say an 8.8 is a fair one. Well, objectively, I am going to give it a 9.8 out of 10 because obviously most people are gonna enjoy it more than I did, even because he's a pretty popular soloist. But even then, I think people are gonna recognize that the beat should have gone a little bit harder, because it definitely was going for that. I feel like that's exactly what they were aiming for, but I don't know what happened. They just didn't do the beat hard enough. So even then, it's still not a 10 out of 10. At least I would say, in my opinion, that's how most people will feel like. So yeah, I guess without further ado, let's move on to the next song, that being One Team's ULLAELI KKOLLAELI, in 3, 2, 1. I have no information about them, so if you have any, if you know anything about them, comment it down below. I don't even know what to expect from this. Okay. You piqued my interest. Okay, so far I like the instrumental a lot. I don't know why, but I don't know, just the music video feels, the concept feels kind of fresh, and I love that. Okay, I don't know what it is with this music video, but I'm loving it. It feels fresh as hell. I don't know how to explain it. It feels so modern and fresh and interesting. I'll definitely react to this one a second time. Oh, it's Ore Koreri. Okay,
ULLAELI KKOLLAELI ULLAELI KKOLLAELI ULLAELI KKOLLAELI ULLAELI KKOLLAELI ULLAELI KKOLLAELI Get ready for the day, yeah. 살다 보면 나
I love this guy's hair. I love how half of it is red and half of it is black. It's so cool. I wish I could do that. Okay. Okay, for the song, I'm a little bit not sure about it, but the music video is so interesting. I love it. It's such a fresh and creative and interesting one. I love it. I guess the best way to explain how I feel about it is, and I know it might be a weird way, but it feels like this is how K-pop is going to be 10 years from now. That's how it feels. I don't know. Hopefully you understand what I mean. It just feels like I'm looking into the future of K-pop. I know, it's a weird feeling, I don't know. Okay, we're definitely getting into this one more time. In 3, 2, 1. Someone's jealous. And honestly, it's surprisingly high quality and high budgeted music video. Yeah, I definitely need some information about this group. Yeah, I love this part. This is such a creative and unique concept. I love that. Yeah, that future K-pop feel still is there. I love it. I also love this guy with the brown hair. Oh my god, this is so cool. I really hope there are good reactors who have reacted to this song, because I wanna see what other people think about this one. This is such an interesting one to me. The song itself, I don't know if I'm gonna really listen to it, but the music video is so fun to watch. For the song itself, I'd say the one thing I know I like for sure is the instrumental. The rest, I would say it's catchy enough, but it's nothing really that is blowing me away. The music style reminds me a little bit of Wannawe. Okay, that part is cat. Also, some of their hair fields remind me of D.A.D. Like, their looks remind me a lot of V.A.V. This is such a weird scene. Let me go, let it. Oh, don't make me want to yawn. I'm already tired. 오케이. This group has definitely piqued my interest quite a lot. From what I saw of them, because I checked at least a little bit about the group, very little, just how many members there are, under which company they are, and I saw that they have at least one more song called Vibe. I think that's the song they debuted with, so in some of my next videos, I'm definitely gonna check that one out, because I really want to see more songs from them, because this one is... It's interesting at the very least. The music video is amazing. I love it. It's so creative and interesting and fun to watch. The song is not necessarily my thing, but I still really enjoy it. And it's a fun, entertaining and quirky song. And I like it. I like it. I wouldn't say I love it, but I like it. And it's catchy enough. So, yeah. I feel personally I'm gonna give this one an 8.7 out of 10. Because I find it really enjoyable, but I definitely would have enjoyed it much more if it was a darker, edgy concept. If you know, if you watch my videos, you'll know that by now. It's not like I do not enjoy fun and quirky kind of concepts, but dark and edgy is just what I enjoy the most. That's true for other types of media as well, not only for K-pop. Objectively, I'm going to give it a 9.3 out of 10 because I think it's a fucking amazing and in a way, I guess it reminds me a little bit also of 17's music because they also do the kind of like fun and quirky kind of music, like especially with the recent comeback Left and Right. But yeah, I really like this group. They definitely managed to make themselves stand out right off the bat. They stand out more than some other groups that I've reacted to, like DKB, even MCND, which is a group that I would say their style is very much my thing, but I feel like they need a little bit of a more of a standout sound for them, because so far it's a bit too similar to other groups like NCT. I feel like it doesn't stand out as much, but this one does, even though it's not exactly my thing, so I really like them. I can't wait to see more from them, and I'm definitely gonna be checking out their debut song and if they have any other B-sides or whatever. I just don't know when it's going to happen because I just have to start doing a little bit more K-pop videos because I'm so far behind in terms of reacting to album B-sides. I'm still all the way back to Monsta X's album, and we're already, what, 2 months since then? So yeah, I'll have to get back on that. And it might take a while for me to react to it, but I will eventually. So yeah, if you're interested, please leave a like and subscribe. And same thing if you enjoyed this video. And also, you can check out the links in the description to my Twitter if you want to follow me there, and to my Wattpad, where I post my stories. Because in addition to doing all these videos on my channel, I'm also a writer. And additionally, I also have a blog on which I review TV shows, movies, cartoons, anime, video games, anything like that you can think of. I just don't do it as often as you might expect or as much as I want, but I do them. I would say at least one post weekly I will be doing. So if you're interested in that, and also on that blog, I'm sometimes gonna be doing top 10 K-pop lists. Like for example, at the end of the year, I'm gonna do top 20 K-pop songs of 2020, top albums of 2020, and top K-pop B-sides of 2020. So if you're interested in that, go over to that blog and subscribe or follow it or whatever you're supposed to do to a blog, because I'm new to it, I don't know the terminology. And if you end up enjoying the blog, you'll end up enjoying my stories or simply enjoy my videos, you can head over to Patreon or Subscribestar where you can pledge support and help keep the channel going, help support me so I can keep writing the stories you enjoy and write the blog posts that you might enjoy. And additionally, I just want to mention that all the money you decide to support me with are gonna go towards my transition fund. Because if you're new to the channel or just haven't noticed at this point, I'm actually trans, but I still haven't started my transition. I'm hoping to do so in the next few months. So if you could help me out monetarily, that would be greatly appreciated. But if you don't want to do it, that's completely fine. You can still help me out by liking this video, subscribing, and especially sharing this video with someone who you think might enjoy it. And I think that's pretty much it for this video, so hopefully I'm gonna see you in the next one. Bye!